In this problem, we're asked to find the area of the surface generated when x equals 1/4 e to the 2y plus 1/4 e to the negative 2y on the y-interval, negative 1 to 1, is revolved around the y-axis. So first, let me just very quickly show you what this function looks like. Although I guess technically I shouldn't call it a function, but what this graph or this relationship looks like. This is actually the shape we get if we graph this, and we are looking specifically at the y-interval from negative 1 to 1. So about from here to here, this segment of the curve, and we are taking this and we are revolving it around the y-axis. Okay, so perhaps you can picture what that surface might look like. So how are we going to go about computing this area? Well, we've seen a formula for surface area in the past for a surface of revolution, so let me remind you what that looked like. We had the integral from a to b of 2 pi f of x square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared dx. And this was for some function f of x that was positive and differentiable. And we were revolving it around the x-axis, and then this gave the area of the surface generated. But here our situation is just a little bit different. Instead of y equals f of x, I have x equals, we'll say, g of y, and I'm revolving it around the y-axis. Right, instead of the x-axis. So instead, I'm going to use a formula that looks very similar. I'm just going to do everything in terms of y, right? Since our relationship is in terms of y and we're going around the y-axis. So then I'm going to integrate 2 pi g of y square root of 1 plus g prime of y squared dy. And beyond that, our process is going to look pretty much the same. So let's start thinking about the different elements that we're going to put in to this integral. Okay, so first of all, I have my curve, g of y, which we're given. That's 1/4 e to the 2y plus 1/4 e to the negative 2y. Okay, we also call that x equals. And so I am going to need to find the derivative of this expression. And when I find the derivative, I'm actually going to be taking the derivative of x with respect to y. Okay, so I'm taking the derivative with respect to y, which is a little bit different. Okay, so if I do that then, I'm going to keep my 1/4. And then the derivative of e to the 2y is e to the 2y times 2, and then plus 1/4, and then the derivative of e to the negative 2y is e to the negative 2y times negative 2. Okay, so if I clean that up a bit, I have 1/2 e to the 2y minus 1/2 e to the negative 2y. There's my derivative. And while we're here, let's go ahead and work on squaring it. So I'm going to have this entire quantity squared. So what I'm going to have to do here is actually FOIL this out. Right, so squaring something is multiplying by itself. So here, if I FOIL this out, I've got first terms, 1/2 e to the 2y times 1/2 e to the 2y is going to give me 1/4 e to the 2y quantity squared. Okay, and then I've got outer terms, I'm going to have 1/2 e to the 2y times negative 1/2 e to the negative 2y So e to the 2y times e to the negative 2y is just going to give me 1. So then really what I'm going to have is minus 1 half times 1 half, or 1 fourth. And then same with my inner terms. I'm going to have another minus 1 fourth. And then my last terms are going to give me plus 1 fourth e to the negative 2y quantity squared. Okay, so that's going to be 1 fourth if I square e to the 2y. Power raised to a power, you multiply the powers. So this is 1 fourth e to the 4y minus 1 half plus 1 fourth e to the negative 4y. So now that we have all our details worked out, let's go ahead and incorporate this into our integral. So my bounds on my integral need to be y values since I'm integrating with respect to y. And I'm told in the problem that I'm looking at the y interval from negative 1 to 1. So those are going to be my bounds. Okay, I've got a 2 pi, which I could put out front if I wanted to. And then I've got g of y. So here that's 1 fourth e to the 2y plus 1 fourth e to the negative 2y times the square root of 1 plus g prime of y squared, which is this expression we just worked on finding. So 1 plus 1 fourth e to the 4y minus 1 half plus 1 fourth e to the negative 4y. And we are integrating with respect to y. So if I simplify a little bit under my root, I'm going to get the following. The square root, I can combine the 1 and the minus 1 half. So I get 1 fourth e to the 4y plus 1 half plus 1 fourth e to the negative 4y. And this quantity here can actually be factored as a perfect square. I can write this as 1 half e to the 2y plus 1 half e to the negative 2y times itself. Okay, and you can check that by foiling that out and confirming that you do in fact get what's underneath the square root. Okay, so then once again, let's rewrite our integral a bit. So I still have my 1 fourth e to the 2y plus 1 fourth e to the negative 2y. But then I've got the square root of the quantity, 1 half e to the 2y plus 1 half e to the negative 2y squared, dy. But what happens when I take the square root of something squared? Well, what I'm going to be left with in that case is actually the absolute value of whatever was underneath that square root. So here, if I simplify, I'm going to have the square root, or sorry, the absolute value of 1 half e to the 2y plus 1 half e to the negative 2y, dy. But let's notice something else here. This quantity, 1 half e to the 2y, plus 1 half e to the negative 2y is actually positive for any y value, right? These exponential functions here are always positive. So I actually then don't need those absolute value symbols. So what I end up with is the following. So where do I go from here? Well, I've got this integral of 1 fourth e to the 2y plus 1 fourth e to the negative 2y, that quantity, times a quantity 1 half e to the 2y plus 1 half e to the negative 2y. So it looks like if I FOIL this out, then I might just be able to integrate it, just term by term. So then let's FOIL inside that integral. So if I do that, I'm going to get 1 eighth e to the 4y for my first terms. Outer terms, I've got e to the 2y times e to the negative 2y. That's going to be 1. So I just have 1 fourth times 1 half. So plus 1 eighth. Inner terms are also going to give me plus 1 eighth. Last terms are going to give me plus 1 eighth e to the negative 4y. Okay, so that's 2 pi integral from negative 1 to 1 of 1 eighth e to the 4y plus 2 eighths, or 1 fourth. Plus 1 eighth e to the negative 4y dy. So if I wanted to, I could actually pull a 1 eighth out of everything and put this as 2 pi over 8 integral from negative 1 to 1 of e to the 4y. 1 fourth divided by 1 eighth is 2, so plus 2. Plus e to the negative 4y dy. And now we're finally at a place where we can integrate this pretty straightforwardly. So I have a pi over 4 out front, and I'm going to go ahead and take the antiderivative. The antiderivative of e to the 4y is 1 fourth e to the 4y, and then I'm going to get plus 2y and then minus 1 fourth e to the negative 4y. And I'm evaluating between negative 1 and 1. So that's going to give me pi over 4 out front. And then if I go ahead and plug in 1, I'm going to get 1 fourth e to the fourth plus 2 minus 1 fourth e to the negative fourth. And then minus, and then quantity, and I'm going to plug in negative 1. So 1 fourth e to the negative 4 minus 2 minus 1 fourth e to the fourth. So then inside my brackets here, if I distribute that subtraction, I have 1 fourth e to the fourth plus 2 minus 1 fourth e to the negative fourth. And then minus 1 fourth e to the negative 4 plus 2 plus 1 fourth e to the fourth. Combining terms, I have my pi over 4 out front, and then inside my brackets, I have two factors of 1 fourth e to the fourth. So that's 1 half e to the fourth. I have two factors of 2, so plus 4. And then two factors of negative 1 fourth e to the fourth. So then minus 1 half e to the negative 4. And we'll stop here. All right, so this is our surface area in this case.